When it's garbage collection day in my neighborhood, I drive past rows of wheelie bins, many of them filled to bursting. And until recently, I've never really thought about how much goes to waste in today's world. Then I learned that some 12 million South Africans go to bed hungry each night, while on the other side of town, many of us are tossing some half-eaten fast food into the bin. It puts things in a different perspective, and that's why it's so exciting to hear about the V3 event, which promoted a message of veganism, sustainability, and social responsibility. Let's find out how it all came together and how it can change our own lifestyles.
I'm at the V3 event today in Johannesburg, Sandton, and I'm so honored to be wearing this beautiful sari, which is both vegan and vintage. And if you're not sure what those words mean exactly, stay tuned because it will all be explained later in the show. This event tonight encompasses food, fashion, and everything that allows us to live consciously both within ourselves and in the world.
A vegan lifestyle doesn't begin and end with the food, as Preetha Fakir explained.
Preetha, welcome to Mela. What is the difference between vegetarian and vegan cuisine?
Vegan is quite diverse in the sense that the word is not only just referring to the food that you eat, but the lifestyle follows that of vegans in the sense that whatever products they eat or use, whether it's cosmetic, whether it's clothing, nothing must be tested on an animal or any animal product in there. I think that's where the whole trend is going now towards, is conscious living in everything that you do. Are you conscious about where you attain the product? And I think our collaboration with Vintage Recycling, which is the recycling of old vintage saris and stopping the landfills, which is based on waste management, which is so crucial. It all blends in together and it all comes down to what you eat.
The aims of the event dovetailed with the principles of Krishna consciousness espoused by ISKCON, and Kerusha met the president of the Sandton chapter.
Welcome to Mela.
Thank you, welcome.
How does an event like this fit in with the aims and intentions of ISKCON Sandton?
This event is kind of showcasing how we're not kind of disconnected from society. We care about the environment, we care about the planet, we care about animals, we care about people.
Presented by the International Inspiring Women Foundation, the V3 event aimed to bring together business people, creatives, influencers, and professionals to raise their awareness of how even small changes in our everyday lives can have a tangible impact on the world. Kerusha met up with the organization's founder and president, Anusha Singh.
Anusha, welcome to Mela. Can you tell us a little more about tonight's event?
For the first time ever, we're having a vintage vegan fashion show. So the vintage comes from India. So we actually went sourcing fabrics that are more than 100 years old. We have put some of them on mannequins and some of them will be on the model, hand woven from a history gone by. So the whole idea of this event is about bringing people together and be conscious, be intentional, but more importantly, try and be aware to save our planet, our environment, and be good to our people and make our best effort every day.
This truly was an event with a vision that went beyond fashion, promoting a message of conscious living while also raising funds for ISKCON Sandton's project to serve 1,000 plates of nutritious vegan food to the poor of Alexandra every day.